number for Soufriere from St Jacques.
You got it, buddy. You got it. I'm going to do that for you.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, I rise to give my unwavering support to the motion as presented by the Honorable Prime Minister and Minister of Finance to borrow US $100 million for the redevelopment of HIA. This, Mr. Speaker, I believe validates that we are delivering on the mandate, yes, which was presented by the Honorable Prime Minister in the Appropriation Bill of 2018-2019 under the theme Building Resiliency Today to Secure Our Future. And of course, Mr. Speaker, the motion before us clearly indicates the interest in attaining resiliency in our infrastructure with the construction or the redevelopment of HIA. I must say, Mr. Speaker, we have been entertained and amused this afternoon by the members opposite. That is all it is, entertainment and amusement. Nothing factual, nothing logical, nothing sensible. Just pure entertainment and political stunts, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, it seems to me that the members opposite, particularly the member for South, Castro South, and to an extent the member for Viewfort North, their only interest is about the contractors and subcontractors. But if I go through the motion, Mr. Speaker, the motion today is simply to guarantee the loan agreement for SLASPA. And the terms of the guarantee are stated right there in the motion, A to D. That's what we came here for, to guarantee the loan agreement. That's all it is.
We should ask no questions.
If you had questions about who are the contractors or subcontractors, refer it to SLASPA. They are the implementing agency. Ask SLASPA about subcontractors and contractors. And why is it you all are so interested in contractors and subcontractors? Leave that to SLASPA. Hold a forum with SLASPA. Or direct it to the minister. The minister will direct you to the relative personal agency. Mr. Speaker, the only good thing we have heard from the members opposite today is the fact. Is the fact that they agreed, they are all in agreement, that the airport redevelopment is a must. That we must undertake the redevelopment of HIA. That is the only good thing we've heard from the members opposite today, Mr. Speaker. And, Mr. Speaker, as the Prime Minister alluded earlier on in his deliberations, in his statement, in about 12 years' time, this government, this country, SLASPA, would have paid off the airport.
Instead of 40 years.
So it means that, Mr. Speaker, the 18 years of the additional monies which would have gone to a foreign entity will now stay in St. Lucia, and we can use it in the infrastructure of this country, in the socio-economic development of this country. And that is prudent management, Mr. Speaker. Only the workers on this side of the Honorable House could come up with an agreement like this. And let me say, Mr. Speaker, that the solution to the development of HIA did not just come overnight, you know. It did not just come overnight, Mr. Speaker. Since 2013, members on this side of the House met with the IFC. And from that meeting, we knew that the agreement was flawed. And we needed to revisit that agreement and put something better on the table. And the Honorable Prime Minister, with his resoluteness and his resiliency to the development of this country, approached the Taiwanese government, and today we are in this Honorable House, Mr. Speaker, guaranteeing the loan of $100 million for the redevelopment of HIA. And with the support of the men and women on this side of the House, Mr. Speaker, come next year, early next year, between January and February, we are going to commence the construction of HIA and further improve the livelihoods of the people of the South. And this, Mr. Speaker, this project brings tremendous benefits and opportunities to the people of Soufriere from St. Jacques. From Viewfort South, from Viewfort North, all the way down to Soufriere, shall benefit tremendously from the development of HIA. Development of HIA, Mr. Speaker, brings into perspective home porting of the cruise ship terminal, which we are negotiating right now. And home porting simply means, Mr. Speaker, that on a weekend, the ship is going to be berthed in Vieux-Fort. You are going to have all those flights coming from different parts of the world. Some people come the day before, they embark. Some people come 2 days, 3 days. It means that those people, those individuals, Mr. Speaker, will be staying on island. They will be going to guest houses. They will be going to hotels. They will be going to A&B establishments throughout the southern part of St. Lucia, all the way down to Soufriere. These are people, Mr. Speaker, who will be going to the sites and attractions. Improve business, more business to sites and attractions. More tour guides, more tour operators will come into the foray. New entrepreneurs are going to be emerging because of the development of HIA. New businesses, existing businesses are going to expand, more hiring, and there is going to be that trickle-down effect all the way, Mr. Speaker. Farmers are going to benefit. Fishermen are going to benefit. Taxi drivers are going to benefit. Bakers, just name it. The list goes on and on and on, Mr. Speaker. The list goes on and on. And this is a project that I have to stand on the floor of this Honorable House and support it on behalf of the good people of Soufriere and Fort St. Jacques and the rest of the people in the south of the country, Mr. Speaker. And I want to commend the Honorable Prime Minister and the government, the members on this side, for standing with the Prime Minister and ensuring that we are in this Honorable House today to guarantee this loan for the development of HIE. And therefore, Mr. Speaker, the Honorable Prime Minister, this House have my unwavering support for this loan agreement. And I would like to thank the government and people of Taiwan for coming out and helping us with this loan for the development of HIE. I thank you, Mr. Speaker.